thrills and spills jockeying for position, but it's all about the sprint finish. Welcome to Arena Seva here in Krasnoyarsk and the 29th Winter Universiade. It's time for short track speed skating's fastest event, the 500 meters. Ice is nice and slippy and fast today, I'm told, and the humidity is perfect for some pretty good conditions. This arena has been updated very recently just for these games. In fact, all the arenas here being used at the Winter Universiade have all been upgraded for a first-class multi-sports event. Malagic is the fastest in this first semi-final with a 42.836. She starts in position number two, just outside of her teammate, Katerina Efremenkova, and there she is, representative of the Siberian State University of Physical Education and Sport in Omsk. Malagic there, 35 on her helmet, is at Moscow City Teacher Training University. Yang Yang in position three is representing Shenyang Normal University. And Nicole Botta-Gomez, currently studying in Milan at the Vita Salute San Rafael University, born in Colombia, in Bogota. Semi-final one of the women's 500 meters is underway, and the two Russians have gone out into the lead here. Efremenkova leading the line from Malagic, and they've pulled away from Botta-Gomez and Yang Yang. The Russians have come out hard and fast all day today. Efremenkova still leading from Malagic as they get the bell. Botta-Gomez is down and out. Top two go through to the A final, and the two Russians have made it through, to the delight of the crowd here. Ekaterina Efremenkova going through with Amina Malagic. Now, there was a little tussle right at the beginning of that race. Referees will have a look at this one. We get to have a glance back as well. Efremenkova has got a championship record here of a 43.431, beating the previous time set by Han Yu Tong in Granada in 2015, a 43.573. Straight to the lineup for semi-final two, though. Park in position one, trying to get round that first bend first, and she does, followed very closely by Sofia Prosvanova. Park setting the pace here. This could be a quick time. Monvazine slipping up the inside. The French athlete now right on the heels of Park. Park putting the booster on. And Prosvanova slips back up the inside of the French athlete. Prosvanova in second from Monvazine. But it's Park leading the line. Can Monvazine find a way through? Oh, she looks like she might have done a bit of a shove there from the Russian athlete, but Park takes it on the line from Sofia Prosvanova. Monvazine, well, she took a bump and effectively gave up at that point. Top two go through to the A final. The bottom two go into the B final. I'm not sure that Monvazine actually did give up. I think she felt that the infringement was so severe from Prosvanova that the Russian will get penalised. We see Park coming off the line from position one, doing her job and just powering down the home straight. Sofia Prosvanova holding the line. But, well, I think it's six of one and half a dozen of another there between the two athletes. I wonder if there's going to be an appeal from the French delegation here. Penalty for Prosvinova for the shove. But no time to dwell on that. We move straight on to the men's semi-final. First up, wearing number 123, Denis Nikisha of Kazakhstan, with Park of Korea, Ivlev of Russia, along with his teammate Denisov. Cleanly away. And Nikisha's done his job and got up into first position, followed closely by Ivlev. Park and Denisov trailing a little bit, but Park's put on a bit of a spurt around the top bend. Nikisha still leading the way, but the Russian trying to sneak away through, can't quite make it at the moment. Park luring in third. Now Park goes. Has he left it too late? The Russian goes on to first place. Park comes around the outside, and it's Nikisha who misses out. Konstantin Ivlev going through into first place as Park put on the boosters. Two bends to go. I thought it may have been too late, but Nikisha's legs blew up. And Park Ji-won, the gold medalist from Almaty in the 1500 at 22, goes through along with Konstantin Ivlev. And a time of 40.921 being set by the Russian. Still just a little outside the record set by Kim Duom in Almaty in the last edition of this competition. Semi-final two of the men's 500 metres. Daniil Iborg from Smolensk State Academy of Physical Education, Sport and Tourism. In position two, Lim Jung-jeon from Kyung-hee University. The Frenchman and birthday boy, Quentin Fakok, turned 20 today from Jean Jaurès University in Toulouse. And the lineup is completed by Hong Kyung-hwan of Korea, from the Korean National Sports University in Seoul. Well, Daniil Iborg goes straight up into the lead. The pace is pretty furious already. And wearing helmet number 129 is Lim Yong-jin in second place. Fakok slipped up into third. The four of them tightly together. Lim goes around the outside of the Russian. Fakok looks like he's ready to pounce, but don't rule out Hong Kyung-hwan either. The bell goes. Lim leading. Fakok nearly getting taken by Iborg. Iborg's on the inside. Fakok is going to take this. Oh, very close for second place, but I think Lim's taken that from Quentin Fakok. Fakok had to cling on to claim second spot. Yong-jin confirmed through as a qualifier along with Quentin Fakok. They'll go into the A final. The B final will include Hong and Iborg. Four and a half laps of this 111 meter track. Yang Yang was the national champion in China in 2016. And has the faster of the two personal best times, a 43.604. for the B final in the women's 500 metres between Yang Yang of China and Botta Gomez of Italy. Botta Gomez slipstreaming Yang Yang. Born in Colombia in Bogota, but hometown of Bolzano in Italy, studying in Milan. Yang Yang trying to hold it all out up front. Keeping a defensive line to stop Botta Gomez from cutting in. They'll get the bell this time around. Botta Gomez trying to go around the outside and then cut back in. Yang Yang's led from the start and has just kept a very tight and tidy line and takes the B final here in Krasnoyarsk. Final positions here, all important, but a tough race. The B final is not doing quite enough in the semis to make it through to the A final, so the medals are gone, out of reach. But Yang Yang put in a professional performance, leading from position number one, and then just kept a tight line around the bends. Finishing with a 45.090, and there is confirmation. First Winter Universiad here in Russia. Ariel Malvoisin has been promoted, so a short B final and a fast and packed out A final. So the A final in the women's 500 meters is underway. The two Russians from positions one and two taking the early lead. Efremenkova, leading teammate, Malagich. Malvoisin trying to come up the inside of the Korean, and she's taken her out there. So only three left in the field. The two Russians miles ahead get the bell. Efremenkova leading Malagich. And a big fall there, Malvoisin and Park Ji-young. Park in tears on the ice. She did take a massive hit into the crash mat, and they're calling for medical here, and the Korean coach is looking on. She did take a huge hit. Malvoisin desperately trying to come up the inside. Took Park Ji-young out, who was going at a full canter. Both athletes in severe pain. This sport is brutal. We see Malvoisin coming up the inside, and just the line was just too tight. In fact, she clipped one of the markers, and it was Malvoisin who went further into the crash mats. Oh, there you go. An arm between the legs from the Korean on the French athlete. I don't think that's in any way, shape or form deliberate. I think it's just the momentum of swinging their arms as they go around the corners. Off again, the two Russians in positions one and two, going back into the positions they were before. Ariel Malvoisin deciding to get out front as well. She's moved up into second. Efremenkova leading Malvoisin from Malagich, and Park Ji-young's in fourth. They've left Mikhaila Kuncharova behind. Park trying to get round Malagich, tussling for third and fourth, bronze medal at stake. Malvoisin has moved up into the lead. The French athlete, who was born on Christmas Day, is in the lead. Malvoisin got a silver in the 1500. She's in the gold medal position here in the 500, and she's taken it. Ariel Malvoisin converts silver in the 1500 meters to gold here in the 500 after a spectacular crash. The French athlete from the Paris Dauphine University is the gold medalist here in Krasnoyarsk 2019. Ekaterina Efremenkova got through in second, having been just taken, and Park Ji-young nicked third place from Emina Maligic. A spectacular race, a 43.919 finish for Auriel Noël Monvoisin. She's the gold medalist here in the Sever Arena at the Winter Universiade. And just snuck inside, kept a tighter line. And after the spectacular crash in the first run of this A-final, Monvoisin got back on her feet, decided to go early, and she's the gold medalist here. Grit and determination from Ekaterina Efremenkova, but pipped at the post. And the opposite there for all to see, the joy on the face of Auriel Monvoisin, despair from Ekaterina Efremenkova. Studies here in Siberia, but could only pick up the silver. The bronze goes to Park Ji-eun, but today has been all about Auriel Noël Monvoisin. B final of the men's 500 meters in short track speed skating. So Nikisha, position one, gets to the bend first. A Korean nearly taking a big tumble there on the first bend, and he suffered for it, trailing in fourth. Second spot at the moment is the Russian Daniel Iborg, as Hong Kyung-hwan slips up into third, chasing down the leading two. Nikisha firing on all cylinders. Iborg trying to cut round. They get the bell. Hands all over the place. And it looks like Hong's benefited from that tussle. Nikisha's going to take the B final here in the men's 500 from Hong Kyung-hwan. And Daniel Iborg has to settle for third in the B final. I think Dennis Nikisha, well, he had to pick himself up. I think he would have expected to be in the A final here given his form today. But picked himself up and got himself ready for this B final. A race is a race, and Nikisha wants to win them all. So a strong lineup here for the men's 500 meters A final. Clean start to the A final here in the men's 500 meters, and Konstantin Ivliev getting out from position one into the lead. Two Koreans in second and third, Park leading Lim. But Ivliev, like the Russians have done all day, taking it out from the front. The Koreans working hard together, Lim in the slip of Park. At the moment, Park's doing all the work, slips up the inside. So Park leading, and now Ivliev's been swallowed up by Lim as well. Park leading Lim, Ivliev, the Russian in third. Park takes it. The Koreans worked so hard with each other there. Park did all the hard work. Lim was just slipping him all the way round. And Park saw an opportunity. Ivliev just opened the door. And Park from Dankook University in Seoul, studying physical education, has taken the gold medal here from teammate Lim. Ivliev of Russia takes bronze. You can see just how much hard work Ivliev did. But Lim spotted an opportunity to take the inside line. And then Lim swallowed up Ivliev as well. Into the final bend. And that's what it means to Park Ji-won. He is the 500 meter champion here in Krasnoyarsk. So there is confirmation of the A final results. Park Ji-won of Korea takes the gold in a time of 49.27 from teammate Lim. Konstantin Ivliev of Russia takes the bronze medal here in Krasnoyarsk. Victory ceremony for the 500 meters. The presentation of the winners of the medals for the 500 meters women's event. In bronze medal position, Park Ji-young of Korea. She was very, very upset at the end, Ekaterina Efremenkova. She came here for the gold medal. Polite, having been involved in that tumble, Aurélie Noël, mon voisin of France, picked herself up, took herself up into the front two in the final, and powered her way to the gold medal. So gold to mon voisin, silver Efremenkova, and bronze to Park. So in the bronze medal position, he's got a big smile on his face. That's Konstantin Ivliev. The silver medal goes to Korean athlete Lim Yong-jin. Oh, he might sneak the gold here. The golden boy. From Korea, Park Ji-won. Medal and a trophy, and of course Yulaika, the mascot of these games, will be handed over. Well, there we have it from session two of the short track speed skating in Sever Arena at Krasnoyarsk 2019 and the Winter Universiad. Confirmation of our medalist in the men's event, Park taking gold from his teammate Lim, and the Russians being kept happy here in the heart of Siberia as Konstantin Ivliev picked up the bronze medal. Superb racing all day today. One more to go here in Sever Arena. Join us tomorrow for the 1,000 meters between the men and the women and the conclusion of the relay races. We hope you enjoyed today's coverage.